God said, I'm going to bless you, my son and my daughter, and we are still here. So I'm going to close with this last poem. And this poem is called The Elevator. Now, if you're on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, please look me up. It's Black Ice, B-L-A-Q. Believe in the Lord, ask questions. Ice, intelligent, creative, and extraordinary. So if you're on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, please connect with me. Somebody say, the elevator. The elevator. Somebody say, the elevator. The elevator. Listen to me good, family. Here we go. There's this elevator, right? It's full of people. Some family, some friends, some strangers. But you're all in the basement. See, the basement represents that brand new idea that was blessed to be manifested in your mind. But by the time you share your idea with the 10 people standing in the elevator next to you, some of them get off before the door even closes. Sort of like those so-called friends. The ones who you thought would be there through thick and thin didn't even make it to the first floor. The door closes. The elevator rises. Much to your surprise, you're making progress. The bell rings. You're at the first floor. The door opens, and guess what happens next? With those childhood friends, they got goals of their own. Time for you to be strong, because you're going to lose some of these friends during this ride and feel alone. But as they walk out, a few more friends walk in. You started off with 10, but now you're down to 8. Now, one of the new friends who just walked in pressed floor 2. So you know what that means. The next time the elevator door opens, they'll be going too. But before they left, they introduced you to one of their friends who became your friend. Then y'all became close like kin. The door opens at floor 2. You lose a few, but one man walks in. And he becomes your boyfriend. And now we're down to 7. Now only 4 out of the 7 are the original occupants that you begin with. In all, there are 2 strangers. 1 cousin, 1 friend, your mom, 1 new friend, and a boyfriend. Now the elevator passes floor 3. Seems like life is finally looking up. But as soon as you get comfortable, you're at the 4th floor and the door opens up. You're staring death right in the face. Quickly you step back, he reaches in his arm and unexpectedly takes your mom. Everyone in the elevator consoles you. But this takes an emotional toll on you and your relationship. Everything you ever believed in or ever knew about is in doubt. You become so emotionally cold that right before the doors close, your boyfriend walks out. What's to expect by floor 5? Now, what just happened on the 4th floor was a game changer. But by the time floor 5 arrives, you will lose one of those strangers. But before he leaves, he whispers to you, there's something that I hope that you see. She said, what's that? That God wants you to go through everything that you're going through in order for you to get to where he wants you to be. He leaves. 4 remains. Only 1 more floor to go. But between the 5th and the 6th floor, you notice something. The other stranger reaches around you and hits the stop button. Everything is frozen. Except you and him. He said, okay, it's time for us to talk. Now, I've been here since the beginning. And I've seen everything that happened, but not once did you ever acknowledge me. I even gave you words of comfort when you lost your mommy. I thought at that point, you would want to get to know me. Look around. Out of the 10 that you started out with, there's only a few. Now you have a choice or two. You can continue on. Use the experience of what you've been through to help heal, or you could do what you've been thinking, go in that person, take those pills. She said, no, I want to live. Then you need to learn how to forgive. She now knew who she was talking to. She takes a deep breath and asks for forgiveness, but he said, I'll forgive you when you learn how to forgive yourself. He pressed the button. The bell rings. The door opens at the 6th floor. To your surprise, your ex-boyfriend is standing there. Offer you his hand. You turn right around, look at that man right in the face and smile. See, out of the many people that have already come into your life, you've already lost the majority. Expect for the ones closest to you to disappoint you, let you down, betray you, but don't you change, stay you. And at the end of the day, when you place your family and friends before God, He will remove them to show you that He's a jealous God. And none should be placed before Him. Trust Him to know that He will replace everything stolen, restore everything lost, and heal everything broken. See, in life, you're going to have some knockdowns on the way up. But it's not about how many times you get knocked down. It's about how many times you get back up. Thank y'all so much. I'm Black Ice Family. I have CDs available if y'all want to support. Thank y'all so much.